Hi and welcome to another week of Moments with Mike and Lois.
Hi.
So we started a new series.
Brand new series.
Sunday.
Yeah.
And a scripture that's really well known, John 15. If you remain in me, I'll remain in you.
Mm.
And I was really talking about the fact that we love that scripture because it's full of promise. And we love the Bible even more when we see promises.
Promises attached to it.
But with the promise comes a proviso. Mm-hmm. It comes with a responsibility.
Mm.
If you will, I will. And I like the way that Jesus kind of puts the emphasis on us doing something, almost like before he will.
Yeah.
But actually, it's because he's already done
exactly
what he needs to do.
Yeah.
So it's like, well, you now need to accept what I've done in order for this to be developed in your life.
Yeah. And that's the way around that it's got to be, isn't
yeah.
it? Is it because he's already done what he needs to, it's our move.
Right.
He's made the move.
Right.
He was the first. It wasn't like, well, you go first. He already has gone first.
Yeah.
He's already done. It is finished. It's complete.
Yeah.
Everything that he needed to do was done there on the cross.
Right.
But now it's our turn.
Right.
It's our responsibility now.
We'll go into it a little bit tomorrow because there's a passive and an active side to it. But I shared a new kind of illustration because I felt like people perhaps can't totally relate to what Jesus was using as an illustration.
Sure.
So I kind of went into a new way of kind of illustrating it.
For the non-gardeners.
Yeah. Me. That's why I did it because, hey, you know, I'm a non-gardener.
Yeah, because Jesus uses it as an illustration talking about the vine and the branches.
Yeah.
And he was talking to a society that understood agriculture. They,
right.
you know, it was very much part of their lifestyle and their work base.
Yeah.
Us, not so much.
No.
So you brought it kind of right back to the 21st century and you talked about us being the appliances.
Yeah.
And Jesus being the electric.
Right.
And so, yes, we had props, more props.
Yeah.
Lots of props. And a fire extinguisher.
Right.
Yeah. Close by.
We should have had.
Yeah.
I laid some foundation about how there's this active and passive side to this particular couple of verses.
Yeah.
And we'll kind of go into that a little bit more tomorrow. Mm. But just to maybe introduce the first one today and say the passive side is all about his love and basically everything that he's done for us. And that's passive because we only have to activate that once.
Mm.
We have to believe that he loves us, receive his mercy and his grace.
Yeah.
And once we've done that, it's like we're in.
Yeah.
We're in. You know, we have a place in heaven once we've done that.
Yeah.
We start that journey of unfolding that love.
Right.
Whereas the other side of it is an active side.
Mm.
But we'll talk a little bit more about that tomorrow. But I just wanted to kind of leave that thought with people today.
Yeah.
That God loves you regardless.
Yeah.
And nothing can change that. Once you accept it, nothing can change it.
That's right.
Mm. Okay, well, we'll come back with some more tomorrow. Whatever you're doing today, have a great day.
Yes.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.